Hello everyone, I'm Santiago Santiago, and today I'm gonna be testing Nier Automata on the GTX 1650 Super. To skip to any of the resolutions tested, check the timestamps down in the description. So while I'm testing this game like I do on all my cards in general, because it's one of my favorites, and usually affordable on the Steam sales, the only problem with this one is that it's not a good PC port at all. It's never gotten any patches, so modders had to fix it. You heard that right, you need to download a mod for the game to work properly, or to get most of the fixes done. There's a link to it down in the description if you're interested. It's called the FAR mod. First of all, I'll talk about the options menu. Not the one in the mod, but the one in the game itself. You got options for resolution, anti-aliasing, blur, shadows, effects, and ambient occlusion. On the anti-aliasing option, it seems to be MSAA. I recommend you avoid this one as much as possible. It's a huge performance hit. Then the blur option is the motion blur. I personally don't enjoy this effect, but if you want to use it, it's there. Then we got shadows. That controls the resolution of shadow maps. Lower this if you want a little higher performance. Then we got effects, which is only high or low. And finally, ambient occlusion, which is on or off. But the ambient occlusion option doesn't only control ambient occlusion, it also controls the post-process anti-aliasing, which is the less demanding anti-aliasing option, which we usually see on games. The SMAA or FXAA is one of those, not sure exactly which one it is, but it looks pretty good in this game, at least in my opinion. Without it, the game has a ton of jaggies, or at least more obvious jaggies. For the best performance, make sure to not use the anti-aliasing option, lower shadows, effects, and ambient occlusion together, and that should be the biggest difference in performance by only using this menu. I recommend you keep it on the maximum, except if you're going for past 1440p or something like that on this card. Inside the game, with the mod installed, should bring you a small window that says all the options that you have. And the one to improve performance the most is called Global Illumination Quality. You got ultra, high, medium, low, or you can just turn it off. By default, the game is on ultra. By just lowering it to high or medium, it's already a huge performance difference. So make sure to tweak this option if you're trying to get more frames. This is the most important one to tweak. That's why I'm saying this mod is absolutely necessary to enjoy the game. In this card in particular, by just using ultra lighting and ultra and everything else on 1080p, it's already way over 60 frames per second, so you don't really need to mess around a lot with this mod, on this card at least. But then if you go to 1440p or 4K, you're going to need to lower the global illumination quality to get better frames. There's also an option to remove the 60fps cap, since, yeah, this game has one for some reason. You can just enable that and the game will be on an unlocked frame rate. Everything seems to be working properly going past 60 frames per second. And in this card in particular, you can play 1080p 60 with ultra settings, then 1440p between 40 and 60 frames on ultra settings. But then if you lower the global illumination quality from ultra to medium, you can do 1440p 60 frames per second. And then at 4K, it was impossible to get 60 frames consistently, even at the lowest settings. But if you want better quality at 4K and don't mind being below 60, you can use a mix between high and ultra, and it should be over 30 most of the time. Personally, I recommend playing this game at 60, is significantly better to control. But yeah, unfortunately, it's a terrible PC port that never got fixed, so a modder had to come in and fix the game for us. It's not completely fixed, but it's significantly better than without the mod. So yeah guys, that's about it. I hope you keep enjoying the video, thanks for watching, and see you next time!
Yeah. Thank you.